This is the second in a two-part series where we talk about lithium batteries. In this episode, we will discuss the Victron Energy lithium smart batteries, why we have a battery management system, and again stress test it in the cold and with a range of voltages. In the first episode, we went through the benefits of lithium and discussed the SuperPack battery. Now it's time for the lithium iron phosphate battery smart. There are two voltage ranges, 12.8 volts available in 50, 60, 100, 160, 200, 300 and 330 amp hour sizes, and 25.6 volts available in a 100 and 200 amp hour size. They save up to 70% in size and weight compared with lead acid, and all smart batteries have Bluetooth. That connectivity to each battery allows users to see cell voltages within the battery, its temperature and alarm statuses. Each battery has a number of 3.2 volt lithium iron phosphate cells, depending on what size they are, and the Victron Energy range of lithium batteries smart have integrated cell balancing and cell monitoring built in. There is a cell status that will inform you if your battery cells are balanced or have an imbalance, as well as the time since the battery was fully charged. Each battery has communication cables, so in a multiple battery setup, they can be daisy chained together. Up to 5 batteries can be wired in parallel. To increase a system's voltage to say 24 or 48 volts, these batteries can be wired in series. To integrate the lithium smart batteries into a system, they require a battery management system. There are a number of BMSs available depending on your system requirements, and within each BMS product page there are data sheets and manuals available. There will soon be an overview data sheet so you can see what each BMS does at a glance. Our battery management systems protect each battery right down to an individual cell level. Should a battery cell become under or over voltage, the BMS will trigger a do not charge or do not discharge notice. This can stop loads by turning off a DC source or multiplus if a battery cell is low on voltage, for example, or stop charge sources from say solar or shoreline if the battery has a high cell voltage. Depending on what BMS you choose to suit your installation, they can also sound alarms before disconnecting, reduce a charge current or completely disconnect the batteries. Lithium batteries should not be charged when cold, so the BMS can actively stop that charge. So let's do some tests. At standard room temperature of 23 degrees Celsius, we connected this smart battery to a 12 volt blue smart charger and it accepted a charge current of around 15 amps. This is a standard domestic freezer, and at its minimum the temperature range inside goes down to a chilly minus 30 degrees Celsius, so perfect for our extreme low temperature test. In the datasheet, the lithium smart batteries can be discharged between temperatures of minus 20 and 50 degrees Celsius. After a night's deep freeze, the Bluetooth still worked, and we were able to see the battery was in alarm mode. The initial messages indicated hardware failure, but as the battery was likely outside the maximum minus 20 degrees Celsius range, we continued to wire it to our test board. The M8 signal cables were connected to a smart BMS CL12100, and right away you can see the red LED indicating there is a temperature alarm. The battery terminals are also connected to the test platform. This included a smart shunt, a servo GX and screen, and a Phoenix inverter as the load. As the current battery temperature was outside the datasheet parameters, we waited a while for the battery to warm up a little. We returned and the battery had already risen to minus 18 degrees Celsius, and although still in alarm mode, the battery was operating as normal and allowing a discharge. The battery is still too cold to allow a charge, however. So the battery allowed a load, but disabled the ability to charge at low temperatures. The 230 volt load for this test was a spare camera battery and charger, and despite the negative temperatures, you can see a load was allowed as the voltage dropped. We continued to allow the battery to warm up, and at 6 degrees, the battery changed to ready for use. So the battery allowed the ability to charge normally now that it was above 5 degrees Celsius. Our next test is to see what happens if we try to overcharge the lithium smart battery. We are using a blue smart charger, but have manually increased the absorption voltage to 16 volts. The Victron Energy BMSs are all preset to disconnect a charge once any one of the cells goes above 3.75 volts. As you can see, cell 1 and cell 2 in this battery are above 3.75 volts, so the charging ability has been disabled. We didn't do a test for overcurrent. Each battery has a recommended and a maximum charge current, and chargers should be configured to not go above the specified current ranges as shown in the datasheet. The last test we will do is to put a load on the battery and see how empty the cells can get. In the settings menu, there is a pre-alarm option available. This will give you a bit of time to react and turn loads off, start a generator, or plug in a shoreline, for example. The signal from a BMS is just a signal and doesn't have enough power to sound a horn or an alarm. You can use a new product called a solid switch 104 to do that, however. This can switch up to 70 volts at 4 amps. We continued to have a load on the battery, and one of the cells was able to go down to as low as 2.76 volts before the discharging was disabled. So the battery has stopped a load discharging the battery at low voltage. In this short series, we've put both the SuperPack and the Smart Lithium batteries through some extreme testing and have demonstrated how much of a temperature and voltage range Victron Energy Lithium batteries can go and how they can benefit a system install.